And I'm Brooks.
And we're with the Winkle. And today we are making a flagpole. Brooks is joining us today and he is my nephew. He's also a Winkle kid. He loves getting his Winkle boxes, right,
yes,
Brooks?
Yes.
What's your favorite Winkle project we've done?
My favorite Winkle project is the sponge boat where the air goes out in the water.
Oh, you like that one, huh?
And the helicopter one.
Oh, the helicopter one. That was a fun one, too. Mm-hmm. Well, are you ready to help me build a flagpole today?
Yes.
All right. Let's see what's in our kit.
A wooden dowel and two note cards and two binder clips and some string and three star stickers, one Winkle sticker, and some clay.
Hey, on top of everything else in your kit today, you'll just need a pair of scissors to cut our string and maybe a marker to decorate your flag, and then we're ready to get started. Okay, Brooks, we're first going to talk about a flag. Have you seen a flag before?
Yes.
Have you seen it being raised up on a flagpole?
No.
You haven't?
No.
Okay, well, when you have a flag on a flagpole, you have to pull a pulley, like a rope, that brings the flag up to the top of the flagpole.
Yeah.
So that's what we're gonna make today. And then you're gonna be able to lower the flag and raise the flag. Do you know what we do with a flag when we're trying to remember somebody that died?
We lower it down.
To what point?
To like half.
That's right, it's called half mast. So if somebody died and we're trying to remember them or something tragic happened, we lower the flag to halfway. A flag can represent like a country or a state or even a school. Does your school have a flag?
I think.
It probably does. My school did. So we have our country's flag. We live in America, and so we have what on our flag?
We have red, white, and blue,
right,
and 100 stars.
We have 50 stars.
50.
And 13 stripes. Yeah, but there's flags all over the world that have different kind of symbols on their flags. They could have a shield on it, stars, stripes, sometimes just colors. Does our state have a flag?
Yes.
What's our state that we live in?
Our state is Arizona.
Yeah, have you seen our Arizona flag before?
Yeah.
It has, it looks like a sunset to me, doesn't it?
Yeah.
To look like that to you? Yeah. I love our state flag. So you guys can make your state flag, a personal flag, or your country flag. It's just totally up to you. So should we start decorating our flag first?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, I gave you two note cards, and that way if you mess up on one of your flags, you have another chance to do it the right way. All right? And you can design your flag to be however you want. I gave you stars and a Winkle sticker. Now this Winkle sticker also could go on a water bottle or your laptop or whatever you have at home that you want to put a sticker on, or you could stick it onto your flag. There's also, remember, there's two sides of this flag, so if you want to decorate one side and then decorate the other side differently, you can do that too. These star stickers can be kind of tricky to get off the paper, but basically you're gonna bend your paper back and put your fingernail under there, and then you'll be able to pull up the sticker. Okay, Brooks, did you finish your flags?
Yep.
Okay, what do we have?
I have my American flag.
Cool.
And this flag, I just made it up.
Okay, nice.
And I'm gonna add the Winkle sticker.
Are you? Cool, a Winkle flag. Once you've made your flag, you're going to poke two holes with your scissors or a sharp pencil. One is going to be towards the top of your flag, but not too close, or else you'll rip a hole in here and your flag won't work, okay? And when you're poking your hole, you wanna hold up your paper and poke where you're gonna poke the hole. You wanna make sure your finger isn't behind that because you don't want your finger to get poked. You wanna make sure that your holes line up evenly so they're the same space away from the edge of your paper. Okay, so you're going to take your string, put it over your note card hole, and then poke your pencil through that hole with the string. That's gonna help you get that thread, that string through the hole.
Pull it out
on the other side. Now we're gonna do the same thing with the other hole. Use your other end of your string, poke it through that hole. And pick it and pull it through. Okay, so notice how our string is coming on the top right here and going through both holes that way. Some kids will accidentally put the string through the back, and that's not gonna go up our flagpole very well. So you wanna make sure the string is going through both holes from the same side of the flag, just like yours. Okay, now take your binder clips, and we open these up like this. We put those silver things back, and you're gonna squeeze them. See how that opens up the binder clip? Squeeze them and put them around the top of your flagpole. As close as you can get to the top. You do want a little bit of your flagpole showing. Squeeze it on this side where there's the round parts. You were trying to squeeze it right here, which is really hard. If you squeeze it on the round part, you have more leverage and you'll be able to squeeze it better. And then put those silver brackets back so that they're closed. Okay, now the next one we're going to put down low on our pole. You want it going the same direction, so push it on, close those brackets, and make sure they're lined up. Now, we want to make sure we have room for our clay down here, so don't put it all the way at the bottom. Put it about 2 inches from the bottom, because we want to make sure we have room for our clay. Okay, very good. So we have our top binder clip that's pretty close to the top of our pole, our bottom binder clip that's about 2 inches above the bottom of our pole, and now we're going to tie our flag up. Okay, so I always think it looks best for a flag to have like the flag pole here, and then the flag is waving this way, don't you?
Yeah.
Okay, so if that's how you want your flag, you want to make sure to have the binder clips pointing towards the right. Okay, now you're going to put your thread through that top binder clip. You want to put it through the round part where you pinched it with your fingers. Okay, and then put the bottom through the round part at the bottom. And you want them both through the same side. See how they're both coming from the top and going in? You don't want to get that mixed up. Now turn it over, hold all your string, hold everything and turn it over. Now you're gonna tie a knot. And if knot tying is tricky for you, you're gonna wanna watch me very closely. Before you tie your knot, make sure the string is still in that round part of both binder clips, because it likes to slip into the other part. Okay, so for tying knots, I just wanna show everybody right here. I have my two ends and I cross them like an X, pinch, and bring this thread underneath.
I have my own way of tying.
Okay, and then I'm gonna tighten it, and Brooks is gonna put his finger right there. And then that makes it so much easier, it'll stay so much tighter. And then I'm gonna bring them up again and make another X. And then this end is going to go through the hole. I'm gonna tighten it. Perfect. Now I'm going to trim the excess thread. We don't need that anymore. All done. Okay, we have our flag made. Now we're gonna get our clay out of the package and we're going to make a mound. We're going to mound up our clay, just like a plop. We're gonna put our flagpole in the mound and I like to give it a little twist. And then just keep pressing the clay towards that stick until it can stay up on its own. Okay, and this is air dry clay, so that means if you give it some time, eventually it'll dry. But as it's drying, you're gonna kinda wanna check on it and make sure that it stays straight up and down so that your flagpole sits in that clay straight up and down. Because we want this to be a nice, respectable flagpole, don't we? Brooks, are we ready to raise our flags?
Yes.
Okay, let's do it. So we're gonna pull it. Ah! That's so cool! Ooh, it's waving in the wind. Hey guys, thanks so much for joining us on making our flags today. I had so much fun with my nephew Brooks. Did you have fun, Brooks?
Yes.
That is great. We want to see what you made. So if you have a grown-up, take a picture or a video and put it on social media, tag us at the Winkle Crate. That's at the Winkle Crate, and then we'll be able to see what you made. Have fun making your flag today, everybody. Bye. Bye.